Hello YouTube, I am the only cat on ice, and I will be doing a very simple Hello World tutorial for Ruby on Rails. So the first thing you want to do is open your web browser and type out Ruby on Rails and click rubyonrails.org. You can see I've already got the site bookmarked. Then click on Guides at the top right-hand side of the page. This will redirect you to most of the Rails guides that go step-by-step with you in building tutorial applications. The one we'll be doing is a blog tutorial. This tutorial won't cover the blog application fully, only until we get to Hello World. It will mainly be Windows focused. So, then click the Getting Started with Rails link. The tutorial will assume you have some applications already installed. Scroll down to Installing Rails. Then click or open a new tab on the Rails installer link. Then scroll down and install the appropriate installer for your operating system. I will install the latest one for Windows 10. This will then download. Wait for it to download before following the rest of the tutorial. So after it's finished downloading, go to your download folder and double click on it and click Run. You should always have your operating system prompt you for permission before installing applications. Otherwise, malicious programs can be installed without your consent. Click I accept all of the licenses, then click Next. Now it will install. This may take some time. Go watch a Vine while you wait. Once it's done, click Finish. It will configure some advanced settings in the console, but these are not important for this tutorial for now. Then, to test that the correct version of the applications are installed, we'll type some commands. But let's say this command prompt isn't open. Go to Start and type CMD. Then click on the command prompt application. Now type Ruby RUBY space minus V and then press enter. This should give the version number. If there is an error, something went wrong during the installation. Try reinstalling to fix the problem. Alright, now type SQL light 3 minus minus version. So SQLite 3 space minus minus version. VERSION. It should display the version. Trying to install the individual applications is not a good idea for a beginner. The installer solves most of the problems. Now, let's install Rails. Type gem install Rails. GEM space install space Rails. Press enter. You should be prompted again Select public networks for now and allow access. As you can see, it's installing Rails. The progress is showing in the console. Leave it for a little while, about a couple minutes, and it should be done. If you think it is stuck, say you've waited 15 minutes or more, simply Ctrl+C to stop the process and retype the command and press Enter. Press Y, then press the up arrow key to retrieve the most previous command. Press Enter. There you go. Now type Rails space minus minus version. Enter. There you go. Now we can start creating the blog application. Now we must navigate to the sites folder. CD space period period will help you move backwards in the folder hierarchy. You need to get to your C drive, where the sites folder is located. Type in dir to find out if it is there. As you can see, there is the sites folder. To navigate into that folder, type in cd sites. Now we are in the sites folder. Now we can begin creating the blog application. Type Rails space new space blog. Press Enter. This will now create a simple blog application and install all of the gem dependencies required. Once it is done, it should say at the last line, 1.9.2, nothing to do, yay. Now, let's navigate into the blog. Type cd space blog blog and press Enter to navigate into the blog. If you type in dir, you will see a lot of different folders have been created. The guide explains the uses of them, so for more info, go see the guide. Now we'll begin the Hello World part of the tutorial. We will display Hello Rails on the blog application through our own homemade web server on our development machine. Now for Mac users, it is a bit different, so refer to the guide. For Windows, you have to pass the scripts under the bin folder directly to the Ruby interpreter. So type Ruby, R-U-B-Y, space, B-I-N, / Rails, space, server. Press Enter. This will fire up WebBrick, a web server distributed with Ruby by default. To see your application in action, open a browser window and navigate to http://localhost:3000. There you can see it being displayed. You should see the Rails default information page. To stop the web server, hit Ctrl+C in the terminal window where it's running. To get Rails to say hello, you need to create at minimum a controller and a view. To create a new controller, you will need to run the controller generator and tell it you want a controller called welcome with an action called index. So use this command to do that. Type Ruby space bin / Rails space generate space controller space welcome space index and press enter. This will create several files for you. Go to your file explorer. Go to my computer or this PC and go to your local disk. Then go inside the sites folder. Open the blog folder. And now you can see all the files and folders it's made. Now, go into App Views Welcome and open the index.html.erb file in a text editor. I'm using Notepad++. Delete all of the existing code in the file and replace it with the following single line of code. Now type left arrow H1 right arrow hello comma rails exclamation point, left arrow, right arrow, and control S to save. Now, we need to tell Rails when we want Hello Rails to show up. For more information, refer to the guide, but for now, we are going to streamline a lot of this. Open the file that is located in sites blog config roots.rb in your editor. So open the file roots.rb that is located in the config folder. Find the following line and uncomment it. Hashtag root welcome index. It is line 8. Uncomment it and then save. This will map requests to the controller we previously made. Let's see if this works. Start your web server by running the ruby bin / rails server command. Then go to your browser and refresh the page. If you get this following error, ExecJS program error in welcome index, go to this file. Go back to your text editor, click File, Open, and then navigate to Sites, Blog, App, Views, Layout, application.html. Open it and change application to default for both lines 5 and 6. Then save. Now try reloading the page again. And there we go. That concludes our quick Hello Rails setup. If you had some issues with the tutorial, refer to the guide or Stack Overflow. I hope this helped you and allowed you to set up Rails Hello World faster than other tutorials. Check the description below for more guides or information on certain questions that you may have.